Hey gang, it's Jim Farmer here. It's Sunday the 19th of June, and I just got done making a few plastic fluke type baits, and I'm getting ready to color them. And I thought I'd spend a couple minutes and show you guys how I color these plastic baits. What I do is I use a method that I kind of came up with called dip coloring. There's a lot of people that dip color their baits, but I wanted to try some different things with dip coloring, so I started coloring these little baits here and a few other baits with the quick coat worm dip coloring. And this is the quick coat itself. You can buy this several different places. If you go to some internet search and type in quick coat worm dip, well, you can find different places that sell it, and they have probably about 10, maybe a dozen different colors that you can work with, and these colors can be mixed to color your different baits. Right now I've got a 5-inch fluke here, and I've got a 4-inch fluke, and I'm going to color them in the Spottail pattern. I've already made a few batches of this, and it got kind of popular, so I'm going to try and make a few more and show you guys how to color the Spottail pattern. So the first thing I'm going to do is take it's kind of like a watermelon colored worm dip, and I pour that in the saucer right here and just put a little bit in there, and that's kind of a watermelon color. And then I've got a brown color, and I kind of want to add that to kind of bust up the watermelon color a little bit and give it just a little different color back, just to put a little bit of brown in there. So I put just a few drops of that in there, and then I use Q-tips, and I'm gonna stir the mixture up and get that mixed in really good, just like that. Once I get it stirred up pretty good, I'm gonna take one of my little plastic baits here. I'm gonna grab a hold of the tail. I've got it upside down, and what I'm gonna do is I'm just gonna dip it in there just for a second, kind of let it drip off a little bit, and then I'm gonna set it over here on the paper towel and let it dry. I'm gonna do another one here. The reason why I'm holding the tail up is because this being the Spottail pattern, we don't want to get any of this color on the tail, so I've kept the tail out of the way when I've dipped this in the worm dip. So we're going to do our little 4-inchers here. I'm just going to want to flash that in there just for a second, just to give it some color. And we'll do our next one. Just a real quick dip in there. So we've got our backs colored on these things. And the next thing I'm going to do is I'm going to get a black colored worm dip. Take one of my Q-tips and just dip it in there. Get that Q-tip kind of soaked in the black. And then I'm just going to dot the tails right here, the baits. Let's put a little bit of a black dot on there. We're going to flip it over. Going to hit it again on the end, on the other side with the black dot. Now this coloring dries real quick, so it's already dry to the touch, so it doesn't matter if I get my fingers on it. It's not going to come off on my fingers. So right now, here's what we've got. We've got the dark color on the back, we've got the black dot on the tail, and because when I look at Spottails sometimes I see kind of an iridescent side to them, and it has kind of a blue tint, what I do is I'm going to take just a little bit of blue here, dip it in the blue worm coat, and I'm just going to barely brush it across the top, just barely across the top on both sides. Just enough to barely cover it. And get them all finished up here. Now what you're going to want to do next is, once you get them colored, you're going to want to let it set and dry and soak in just a little bit. The color is soaking into the plastic right now as we speak. A lot of times I just like to get some kind of oil, some kind of worm oil or scent, and put them in the bag maybe 20 minutes after coloring them, just to help get the coloring into the plastic. This is a little oil, and I'll be putting some oil in these baits in a bag just a second to let them kind of soak up that oil. But this is the way they look right after I get done coloring them. And about 48 hours later, well, this is what you end up with. What happens is the color works its way down into the plastic, and the the benefit of having that color do that and just not have a two-colored worm is when you have two-colored worms and minnows and things like that, you have a very defined line between the colors. Whereas when you use dip coloring, why the color line's more subtle. The colors have kind of bled into the white plastic, and so you get kind of a subtle transition in the colors, more so than you would get with like two-part injecting and things like that. That's what I like about these dip colored baits, is the color just kind of blends into the plastic and it gets real subtle.